Silat is an Indonesian type of street fighting, and it's an old type of, it's an Asian type of martial arts, and it's known in the US and elsewhere for movies like Raid.
Yeah, and if you would like to practice this ancient martial art, it's probably a bit difficult to find the right guru to teach you. Isn't that right, Joyce?
Correct. It's very difficult finding a Silat guru or master in the United States for a few different reasons. One being that gurus and masters are very selective about the students that they'll take on. Another is that different tribes teach different styles of Silat, and sometimes they don't want to teach people outside of their group. So it makes for a very secretive martial art form. There's also the reason how in the United States, there isn't a massive Indonesian population here. Therefore, that means less teachers of Silat. Currently, I train under Guru Riana, and the only reason we even connected was because I got a lead on his name, did an extensive search on how to even connect with him. When I finally contacted him, he agreed to meet with me to see if he would take me on as a student.
It sounds great. And why were you and others so keen on learning Silat?
Well, the movies The Raid and The Raid 2 have a huge following in the United States, and it's what gave this martial art form its mainstream publicity, basically. Silat is a great combination of mental, physical, and spiritual strength. So not only am I getting a great workout and learning how to defend myself, but it's helped so much with my stress levels and my patience as well, because you have to learn how to meditate and do mantras. My current guru, Yana, is also teaching me about the scientific side of Silat, where you build up magnetic energy within your body to heal people. I've actually tried it on my grandmother, and it's worked wonders on her ailments.
Really? And what differentiates Silat from Taekwondo or Kung Fu?
I would have to say that Silat isn't just about the sport of it. When you start training in it, you're taught to treat it as a spiritual art form. Basically, every move you make is a connection to something else, whether it's the sun, the water, the earth. And also, I noticed that from a personal point of view, every movement you make is quick and with purpose. You can see that it's a very logical sport and how it was used as a form of survival back in the day. In addition, you have to be well-rounded in all aspects of it, because it is an oral tradition. It's not written down, so it's the only way that it can be passed down to future generations, is knowing everything about it from the culture to the history of it.
Thanks for joining, Joyce. I wish you and your grandma the best of luck with Silat. And if you guys want to know more on this martial art, go to interconnection.com.